Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. Voltage divider. What is voltage divider in electronics? What are the advantages, disadvantages? What is loading effect? How we can analyze this circuit? We will discuss in detail. This is a question from my viewer. He sent me this circuit. He is using 12 volt battery. 1 kilo ohm resistor, 2 kilo ohm resistor, and he is taking V out 1, V out 2. How much voltage will give at V out 1 and 2? And how much voltage we will get if we put two resistors in parallel? How we will calculate the proper resistance to get specific V out? I tried many times to understand the law, but it is complicated. Let's discuss. So if you are interested to understand this topic, I will suggest to watch this video without skipping, because its each step is interlaced with the first and the second. First, I will draw the same circuit. One resistor, second resistor. Here is a battery, 12 volt. This is R1, this is R2. In our case, R1 1000 ohms, this is 2000 ohms. We are taking output at these two points. When we connect resistor, any component with battery, and it is closed circuit, the current will flow. According to Ohm's law, how much current will flow, that will depend on the resistor value. Here are two resistors. That will be called RT. RT is equal to R1 plus R2. I will try my best to explain with more and more details so that we can understand every step easily. RT, total resistance. That is R1, R2, R3. How many resistors are in series? That will be here. 1K. 2K. This is 3000 ohms. How much current will flow in this circuit? That is IT is equal to V in RT. 12 volt, 3000 ohms, 0.004 ampere, 4 milliampere current will flow in this circuit. We need to calculate the voltage value. How much voltage will drop across any resistor, that will depend on the resistor value and the current value. Because it is voltage divider, we can use voltage divider formula, or we can use simple Ohm's law. Voltage divider formula, it is also Ohm's law. Or we can use ratio method, we can use transfer function. Every method will come at the same point. So first step, we will calculate VR1, voltage drop across this resistor. I is 4 milliampere, multiply with 1000, it is 4 volt. Voltage drop across R2, 0.004, because current will remain same in the circuit, because current has only one path, multiply by 2000, so it is 8 volt. This is our reference point, 0 volt, ground level. Return path. From this point to this point, 8 volt. From this point to this point, voltage drop across this resistor, because we are calculating R1, it is 4 volt. And if we calculate total voltage, V in is equal to VR1 plus VR2. 8 volt, sorry, VR1 4 volt plus 8 volt is equal to 12 volt. Applied voltage are equal to dropped voltage in the circuit. So this is first method. Now we will use voltage divider rule. V out, because we are taking output from the low side resistor, that is connected with the low side ground side, that is this resistor. So R2 divided by R1 plus R2 multiply by V in. R2 is 2 kilo ohm, 1 kilo plus 2 kilo multiply by 12, divided it is 8 volt. So this is voltage divider method. We can use this method. So this is V out, because we are taking voltage across VR2, so it is V out. If we are using two resistors, if R1 is equal to R2, then V out is equal to V in divided by 2, because both resistors are equivalent value. That time the output voltage will be V in divided by 2. Then we can take ratio method. R2 R1 plus R2. R2 is 2000 divided by 3000, so it is 2 over 3 ratio. If you want to calculate output voltage ratio, that is this transfer function, it is also called H. 12 multiplied by 2 over 3, 8 volt. Now the problem will start when we will connect a resistor, any load, in parallel to this resistor. This is first resistor, this is second resistor, this is output point. Current flowing in circuit, that is 0.004 ampere. 2 kilo ohm, 1 kilo ohm. Here is 8 volt output. This is 0 volt. Now, if we connect any load resistance across this resistor, because we are using voltage divider formula to drive any circuit, to bicep any circuit, to provide voltage to any circuit. What will happen now? Now two resistors are in parallel. When this resistor was not available at that time, here was just only 1k and 2k resistor. But now an other resistor is in circuit. For example, this is 2 kilo ohm and it is also 2 kilo ohm, 1 kilo ohm, 5 kilo ohm, whatsoever. Let's consider 2 kilo ohms. Now RTA, this section from this node, now the current path will this and this. Current coming from this point will be divided into two sections. Here is maximum current. Then this current is divided into these lines. So let's calculate this portion now. RTA is equal to, this is R2, this is RL, this is R1. Now we will calculate R2 and RL. R2 multiplied by RL divided by R2 plus R. Normally these are equal value resistors, we can divide by 2, but I will use formula. It is 2000 multiplied by 2000 divided by 2000 plus 2000, 1 kilo ohm resistor. Now the equivalent circuit to this one, this resistor, this resistor, now R2 and RL are in parallel and these are considered as RTA, that is equivalent resistor, 12 volt, this resistor is 1 kilo ohm and this is combination of these two resistors, it is also now 1 kilo ohm. Now we can see the system configuration is changed. Before this, here was ratio 1 kilo ohm, 2 kilo ohm. But now 1 kilo ohm, 1 kilo ohm. Now RT is equal to R1 plus RTA, 1000 ohms plus 1000 ohms, it is 2000 ohms. Then IT in this condition, 12 divided by 2000, 0.006 ampere, that is 6 milliampere. Now here is a new problem, that by adding a resistor, load resistor, the current increased. Before this, the current was 4 milliampere, but the system current is now increased, 6 milliampere. Now if we calculate voltage, VR1, 6 multiplied by 6 milliampere multiplied by 1000, 6 volt, VR2 is equal to 6 volt, because now both resistors are equivalent value. When we connected load, current increased, voltage decreased. Now this 6 milliampere, if we see here, 6 milliampere here will divide it, 3 milliampere here, 3 milliampere here. Before this, 4 milliampere. When current will increase, there will more heat dissipation here, power loss. So we are wasting energy here. Two different things. Load will receive dropped voltage, system current will increase. In result, the load efficiency, its efficiency sensitivity will decrease. Voltage decreased, current increased, and efficiency or sensitivity decreased. Heat increased, power loss, power consumption increased. So these indicators will change by adding load resistance to the voltage divider. It is called loading effect. What is loading effect? When we connect any load to a voltage divider, system current will increase, output voltage will decrease, efficiency or sensitivity of the circuit will decrease, heat energy will be dissipated, and power consumption will increase. To compensate these things, we need a careful calculation for the load current. Let's calculate. We will calculate in different ways because it is second part of the question, how we can calculate a proper resistor for any circuit. This is R2, this is R1. In parallel to R2, we are connecting RL. 12 volt supply here. First, we need to analyze the voltage. VL, load voltage, in my example 5 volt. And IL, load current, for example 50 milliampere. When we know these two things, we can calculate resistor value. RL is equal to V over I. VL, IL. 5 divided by 50 milliampere, 0.05. So it is 100 ohms. That means RL is equal to 100 ohms. Let's assume RL is equal to R2. So RL 100 ohms, R2 is also 100 ohms. It is assumed when two resistors are in parallel, because this time we need 50 milliampere in this portion, same 50 milliampere will also flow in this circuit. 50 and 50, 100 milliampere current will flow in this channel, that 100 will divide it here. RTA, that is this portion resistance from this node, R2 multiplied by RL, R2 plus RL, 100, 100, 100 plus 100, it is 50 ohms. Now the equivalent circuit, this is RTA and this is R1. Volt, it is across this RTA 5 volt are dropped here, as we assumed 5 volt 50 milliampere current we need here, the same voltage, because voltage will remain same, current will be divided in parallel, the voltage will remain same, 5 volt here, 5 volt here, that means in this section 5 volt are dropped. How much voltage will across R1? VR1 is equal to VIN minus VRTA, this resistor, VOUT, VIN 12 volt minus 5 volt, VR1 7 volt. VR1, how much resistor value? V over, sorry, this resistor is 50 ohms. As we calculated here, it is 50 ohm resistor. Yes, now it's 5 volt are dropped here. Current here, 5 divided by 50 is 100 milliampere. The same current here, 100 milliampere, because current will remain same. 7 divided by 0.1, it is equal to 70 ohms. Now if we check RT, R1 plus RTA 70 ohms plus 50 ohms, 120 ohms. Now IT, total current, this is cross check, V over RT, 12 divided by 120, it is 100 milliampere, 0.1 ampere, 0.1 ampere. How much resistor power rating? How we can select proper resistance? We know P is equal to I square R. 0.1 square R is 70. 0.1 square multiplied by 70, it is 0.7 watt. Point 0.1 square multiply by 70.7 watt. This is maximum power consumption of the component dissipated power when full current will flow. So we need some extra headroom. The next available limit, that is 1 watt. So we need 70 ohms 1 watt resistor here for R1 and R2. P is equal to I square R. Current value will flow here 50 milliampere, because 50 milliampere here, 50 here, 100 here. 0.05 square, resistor value is 100 ohms. .05 square multiply by 100, that is 0.25 watt. Why we are selecting 100 ohms? Because 100 ohm is load resistance, and 100 ohm we calculate, we assumed here that R2 is equal to RL, so that the total resistance of this node is 50 ohms. So maximum power wattage rating of R2 is 0.25. The next available limit is 0.5 watt. Finally, we can say R1 70 ohms 1 watt, R2 100 ohms 0.5 watt. So this is the proper calculation for voltage divider network to drive a load with rated voltage. But if we will disconnect the load, this is 70 ohm resistor. Physically we are using 100 ohms resistor here, 100 ohms load here. Now we disconnected the load. ...12 volt. Now if we remove the load, check RT. RT is 170 ohms. We can calculate now with any method using voltage divider formula. R2 R1. R2 divided by R1 plus R2 multiplied by Vn. R2 is 100 ohms. R1 70 plus 100 by 12 divided by 170 multiplied by 12 is 7.058 volt. Now we can see, when the load is connected, output voltage will 5 volt. When the 100 ohms load will be connected here, if we remove the load, the voltage will 7.05 volt. And we can also calculate using Ohm's law. RT is this one. I is equal to V over R. V is 12 volt. R is 170 ohms. 12 divided by 170, the amount of current is 0.07 ampere, 70 milliampere. The current is now decreased. Why? We remove the load. When load is connected, 100 milliampere current will flow. IR2. I is 0.07 multiplied by 100 ohms 0.07 multiplied by 100 ohms, it is 7 volt. The same. We can use this method, we can use this method. As we checked, when the load was connected and it was drawing full current, the voltage was 5 volt. Now, by changing the load, by removing the load, the voltage are now increased. System current is changed. So this load variation, sometime the load is drawing more current, sometime it is drawing less current. All the time, voltage will vary on this point based on the load current. So best option to take regulated voltage, voltage regulator, Zener diodes, any type of linear regulator will be used. That is good option. But voltage divider network, now we will discuss its application. It is basic combination, basic element in electronics. If we say multimeter, there are many, many voltage divider combinations in any multimeter that are calculated properly, and we are taking measurements on the multimeter. High voltage probes. Then we are biasing any transistor, any operational amplifier, different circuits. Then it is used in logic shifting, in audio circuits. When we are adjusting the volume from our car tape, from our any audio amplifier, from TV, what we are changing? We are changing the combination of this voltage divider network. We are changing resistance R1 and R2. Slider is moving from low to high. We are taping voltage. So that is the very unique example of this voltage divider. It is also used for sensor measurements. When any resistor combination is connected here and a sensor is connected here, sensor's output is variable. Its resistance is changing. This is standard resistance. So this changing resistance will be measured as an output voltage from any device. I hope this video is informative for you. If it is good, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.